Hi, I'm Kara Berry, host of Everyone's Business But Mine, and I am an all-inclusive addict. Enter Club Med, the best all-inclusive for you and your family. With resorts worldwide, from their family flagship resort, Club Med Punta Cana, to their only mountain resort in Canada, Club Med Quebec, they have everything you need to relax. With their 20-plus sports activities, wellness programs, you can dine on delicious cuisine and make memories with your family. So book your next getaway with Club Med. Visit clubmed.us or call 1-800-CLUB-MED or your travel advisor.
On today's Smart 7, Biden presses go on Ukraine weapon shipments, London flirts with the apocalypse, and much more. It's Thursday, 25th of April. It's World Penguin Day, and happy birthday, Al Pacino.
The Smart 7. It's news, but not the news.
Prime Minister Rishi Sunak continued his high-speed European tour on Wednesday, heading to Germany to meet with Chancellor Olaf Scholz. The focus on the trip was to deepen relationships between England and Germany, particularly when it comes to defence cooperation, with both men agreed that their countries will support Ukraine for as long as it takes. Rishi's been focused on increasing defence spending this week, and he says that the UK and Germany are on the same page when it comes to their priorities.
We meet as a war rages on our continent and new threats are rising around the world, and we stand here today together as the leading defence spenders in Europe, unshakable NATO allies, and the two largest military supporters of Ukraine in Europe.
Ukraine had more good news from the US as, following a bipartisan Senate vote, Joe Biden was able to sign the $95 billion aid bill, which includes $60 billion worth of support for the beleaguered country. The first shipment of arms and ammunition worth $1 billion is ready to roll as Biden celebrated what he called a good day for world peace.
I'm making sure the shipments start right away. In the next few hours, literally the few hours, we're going to begin sending in for air defense munitions, for artillery, for rocket systems and armored vehicles.
Prime Minister's question time had no Prime Minister on Wednesday, and it had no leader of the opposition either. So instead, Deputy PM Oliver Dowden faced off against Labour's Deputy Leader Angela Rayner, and it got pretty spicy pretty quickly. Angela wanted to know if the rumours were true that Oliver has been pushing for an early general election.
Has he finally realised that when he stabbed Boris Johnson in the back to get his mate into number 10, he was ditching their biggest election winner for a pint-sized loser?
The pint-sized loser reference seemed to genuinely shock the Tory MPs, and there was a chorus of boos as they defended their short king Rishi. Dowden came back with a predictable dig at the ongoing tax row over Angela's old council house.
To begin with, it is a pleasure to have another exchange with the Right Honourable Lady in this house, our fifth in 12 months. Any more of these, and she'll be claiming it as her principal residence.
The Commons debated the Renters Reform Bill on Wednesday, legislation which was originally intended to bring an end to so-called no-fault evictions. The ban was first promised 5 years ago when Theresa May was PM, but the government has been slow to move on it, with the latest version of the bill delaying the change until a review of the court system has taken place. Michael Gove had said on Tuesday that he still hopes it will become law, but that it will depend on how quickly the House of Lords move on the bill. The legislation without the ban passed a common vote on Wednesday evening and is now headed to the Lords, and Tory MP Andrew Bowie says that on the no-fault eviction issue, just because the government haven't done it yet doesn't mean they won't do it.
We need to ensure that the action we are taking is proper, legally watertight, and will actually come to the point that we can end no-fault evictions, which is what we are committed to doing.
If the daily news cycle is making you long for the end of the world, you might well have thought your luck was in on Wednesday morning. First Big Ben stopped, and then four horses burst through the streets of London, one of which was covered in blood, in a highly dramatic and apocalyptic scene. But it turned out not to be a dramatic omen. Firstly, Big Ben recovered, although it did bong inaccurately at 10 a.m, and there were actually five horses who got startled by Belgravia builders and were all recaptured. The horses were in fact part of the household cavalry, and they and a number of soldiers were slightly injured in the incident, as commanding officer Lieutenant Colonel Matt Woodward explains.
We would like to express heartfelt gratitude for the swift responses of the Met Police, City of London Police, the Royal Mews, the London Ambulance Service, the London Fire Brigade, and members of the public in reacting as quickly as they did. This enabled swift treatment of our soldiers and helped bring our injured horses to safety.
Still to come on today's Smart 7, Liverpool lose at Everton and Chris O'Dowd has some IT advice. Right after this.
Hi, I'm Dori Shafrir.
And I'm Kate Spencer.
And we are the hosts of Forever 35. And today, we're talking about Club Med, the best all-inclusive getaway for families.
Today, Club Med has nearly 70 resorts worldwide, from beachside resorts in the Caribbean and Mexico, to magical locations in the Maldives and Morocco, to ski resorts in the mountains from Canada to the Alps.
Between their all-inclusive family programming, wellness offerings, land and water sports, and their French heritage-inspired food and drink offerings, Club Med is the best way to elevate your family getaway, no matter which location you're at. To learn more, visit clubmed.us.
Welcome back.
Wednesday night saw four Premier League games, including Jurgen Klopp's last Merseyside derby. Apart from Liverpool and Everton, Wolves welcomed Bournemouth, Crystal Palace hosted Newcastle, and Sheffield United faced Man United at Old Trafford. It turned out to be a night of surprises as Wolves lost at home to Bournemouth and Crystal Palace beat Newcastle 2-0. Manchester United needed a Bruno Fernandes double to secure the win over Sheffield, and the game finished 4-2. But the biggest shock of the evening saw Everton beating Liverpool 2-0, their first home derby win in 14 years, and surely a nail in the coffin of Liverpool's title hopes. Manager Jurgen Klopp sounded deflated after the game.
Obviously, it's not the greatest moment we are in, and we still have to play football games, so you have to fight through, you have to use your moments to build, to get the momentum back if you want. But we were not good enough, that's what we have to admit.
For an Irish actor, Chris O'Dowd has spent quite a lot of his career playing Americans fairly convincingly. And if you haven't seen his Apple TV Plus show Big Door Prize, you're missing out. It's a charming sci-fi comedy in which a mysterious machine comes to the sleepy town of Deerfield, which can reveal your true potential if you input your fingerprints and social security number. Yes, it does sound a bit like a spam email, but series 2 is just about to drop, so Chris popped up on the One Show to chat about his character and the temptation to sneak in one of his IT crowd catchphrases.
There is, strangely, at the end of the season, there's a scene where we're all standing around that machine and all the locals are looking at it and it's not working. And I do have a line that says something like, you should probably turn it off. I didn't want to push it because it felt like it would take people out of the moment of it.
There's not much J-Lo can't do. She can sing, she can dance, she can make Ben Affleck smile. She's a modern wonder. But can she take on artificial intelligence that's hoping to destroy our planet and win? Let's hope so. She stars in the new science fiction slash action movie Atlas, in which she's fired off into space to track down and unplug a deadly AI called Harlan, who is played by Simu Liu. Armed only with her dislike of AI, a ton of high-tech weapons, oh, and a robot assistant called Smith, find out if she can save the day on Netflix from May 24th.
This planet is unstable and inhospitable.
Atlas, my name is Smith.
Is that really necessary? You're a computer program.
I'm driving to LA out of Roscoe.
No, I'm not.
No? What are you then?
I am a computer program named Smith.
No one likes a smart-ass Smith.
You've been listening to The Smart 7. We'll be back tomorrow at 7 a.m. Hit that follow button and have a great day. Give us 7 minutes, we'll give you the world.
Hi, I'm Kara Berry, host of Everyone's Business But Mine, and I am an all-inclusive addict. Enter Club Med, the best all-inclusive for you and your family. With resorts worldwide, from their family flagship resort, Club Med Punta Cana, to their only mountain resort in Canada, Club Med Quebec, they have everything you need to relax. With their 20-plus sports activities, wellness programs, you can dine on delicious cuisine and make memories with your family. So book your next getaway with Club Med. Visit clubmed.us or call 1-800-CLUB-MED or your travel advisor.